So you talk about us moving forward in this relationship, and your involvement in wrestling obviously grows because now you're dating a wrestler, and vice versa, my, you know, world starts to kind of engage into yours. And a big aspect of your life is roller derby, or was at the time and still is to an extent, of course. But of course, academia and your life now here in New Mexico has dictated somewhat of a different path. But roller derby is a passion of yours. It's been a passion for a while. What can you tell me? I can see it. What can you tell me and the listeners, the parallels and the correlations between roller derby and professional wrestling? Before we kind of go into your journey in roller derby, who you are, what led you there, how similar is it to wrestling? Because from my perspective, it's almost a mirror. It's night and day. It's that locker room camaraderie, brotherhood or sisterhood aspect of this underground world of redheaded stepchild sport that only this niche audience really engages with, but everyone kind of loves, you know, without putting all, you know, without taking your thunder. Where do you see the parallels between that?
So, yes, there are a lot of parallels. I feel like it depends on what kind of roller derby we're talking about. So there's two different kinds of roller derby. Just like there is wrestling, you know, there's like
the amateur,
collegiate,
there's a real
yeah,
stuff,
there's a collegiate
there's
wrestling,
the
and there's professional wrestling.
Yes.
Yes. And so same thing with roller derby. There's roller derby as a legitimate sport, and I guess that's probably not the right way to say it, but like, okay, so
we
like
understand
within
the wrestling parallel.
Yeah,
we
yeah,
all
yeah,
understand
yeah. So
what
there's roller derby
is.
That has penalties, and you know, that has rules, and you can get disqualified, et cetera, which is also very fun. I feel like that makes me a better skater participating in roller derby like that, like actually following the rules. But I'm a huge fan of renegade roller derby, which is what was roller derby in like the 80s and the 90s, which was the very performative roller derby where, yeah, we were like wrestling each other on the track.
It's the roller derby we all kind of know and love.
Exactly. So when we think roller derby, we think of, you know, everyone, you know, like elbowing each other in the face, you know, stuff like that, like throwing people like across the track. Like that's the kind of roller derby that I love, which is the one that mirrors professional wrestling. And a lot of the times they do. We take a lot of wrestling moves and we just do them on skates.
Yep. And not only the wrestling moves, but the whole entertainment aspect. Obviously, you guys are doing wrestling moves. You're doing shows. You're breaking out into hockey fights. The referees are involved. There's funny names. There's funny, you know, costumes and designs and all that kind of stuff. And that, again, it takes the concept of sport and the very real aspect of this relay race around the track on roller skates, which between me and the listeners and you is probably the hardest damn thing I've ever seen in my life, right? You might be looking at wrestling and say, how the hell do they do? I'll look at derby and I'll say, how in the hell? No way you can catch me dead. You've seen me on skates and it's not pretty. It's Bambi. It's worse than Bambi. It's drunk Bambi, right? So, you know, taking the concept of sport and mixing that and meshing that with the entertainment aspect of costume and character and promo and you know, worked fight and worked shoot and all that kind of cool stuff, it really, really mirrors professional wrestling. And if we have any older listeners, people that were kind of around in the heyday of the mainstream popularity of the early days of television, you talk about four or five different channels. On one of those was derby, and on one of those was pro wrestling on different right. hours of the day. So do you think that has anything to do with our dynamic? Do you think it's coincidence? Do you think that – because I do. I really do. I think that your affinity for pro wrestling and my affinity, not so much for derby. I do enjoy it through you, but it's not my sport. But my affinity for watching the show business aspect. I could easily sit there and watch a full game of what you would call renegade roller derby and be completely entertained in the same way I would at a live pro wrestling show or the rodeo or any of those kind of not lowbrow, but you understand it's a lowbrow form of entertainment. And that's not to say anything about the people that consume or enjoy or partake in those, because that would be insulting you, me, and the listener. And that's not at all what the comparison's meant to be. But there are very, very similar parallels in the world. And I do think that that plays, if nothing else, the smallest part in yours and I's attraction to each other.